Candidiasis is commonly known as a yeast infection that affects millions of people yearly. From minor discomfort to severe infections, this fungal condition can impact anyone. Today, we'll answer all your questions about candidiasis, its causes, symptoms, treatment, and prevention. First off, let's start with the basics. Candidiasis is a fungal infection caused by Candida, particularly Candida albicans. While small amounts of Candida naturally live in your body, they can spiral out of control under certain conditions, leading to infections in the mouth, skin, bloodstream, or vagina. Common locations for Candida overgrowth include the mouth and throat, known as thrush, often affecting individuals with weakened immune systems. The genital area, known as genital yeast infection, more common in women, causing itching, discharge, and discomfort in the vaginas. The skin, typically occurring in warm, moist areas like skin folds, causing red, itchy rashes or small pustules. Invasive candidiasis, a severe form where Candida enters the bloodstream and spreads to vital organs like the kidneys or bones. Now, what causes this imbalance? There are several factors that can trigger Candida to overgrow. And the common culprits include antibiotics that disrupt healthy bacteria, a weakened immune system due to conditions like diabetes or HIV, hormonal changes during pregnancy or contraceptive use, warm, moist environments that encourage fungal growth, or even stress and sleep deprivation. These weaken your immune system. Symptoms depend on where the infection occurs. For example, for genital yeast infection, women may experience itching, burning, or painful urination, and thick white discharge that looks like cottage cheese. Men might notice redness and swelling of the penis tip. For thrush, the symptoms include soreness, redness, cracks in the mouth, pain when swallowing, and white patches. An invasive candidiasis presents as fever and chills that don't improve with antibiotics and organ-specific signs if the yeast spreads. Diagnosis typically involves a medical history review, discussing medications and diet, and examining skin or mucous membranes. For severe cases, blood or tissue samples may be tested. Treatment depends on the type and severity of the infection. Use topical antifungals, creams, or ointments for mild infections. Use oral medications such as fluconazole for moderate cases, and intravenous drugs. For invasive candidiasis, drugs like amphotericin B are used. Pregnant women should opt for safe topical antifungals like miconazole under medical guidance. To prevent candidiasis, practice good hygiene and keep affected areas dry. Avoid overusing antibiotics. Avoid wearing tight synthetic clothing. Maintain a balanced diet low in excess sugars. Probiotics may help, but always consult your doctor before use. Let's tackle some common questions. Can candidiasis go away on its own? Mild cases might, but untreated infections can worsen. Is candidiasis contagious? Not usually, but partners can occasionally pass it during intimacy. When should you see a doctor? If symptoms persist, worsen, or occur frequently, seek professional help. With proper treatment, most cases of candidiasis resolve quickly and without long-term issues. However, invasive candidiasis requires immediate medical attention to avoid severe complications. Knowledge is power when it comes to your health. If this video helped you understand candidiasis better, give it a thumbs up and share it with someone who might benefit. Check the description for links to helpful resources, and don't forget to hit subscribe for more health tips and insights. See you in the next video on Mindful Healthy Habits.